another trick.
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid baby.
Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Tilly.
The beast is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is down there.
He's always
watching you. She needs to find it.
She's found it.
She lost it and she has to find it.
Give me
the torch alight.
Up. You can do this.
Focus! Watch out!
Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
She never
And now
everything is all her fault.
All her fault was
so weak. She should have known. She should have.
Why doesn't she learn?
She
learn.
She learns.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take...
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Deeper and deeper. The beast knows. The beast knows exactly where she is. She's falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
Plays into his hands. The lights run out. She'll die. She can't. She's going to go through anyway.
What are you doing?
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's lighting the
torch. She's making light. She's making light.
She's got light on the ice.
She'll be safe. Stop! Stop it!
Let go of it.
Stop
letting the memories
follow you. Quick!
Now she can.
Let go of it. Stop letting the memories follow you. Quick!
Nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Keep the torch alight.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
You killed us. You killed us.
Keep the torch up.
Keep the torch up.
You need the light.
My voice.
I'm coming!
I can smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your god.
I am leaving with him!
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillian will rot in hell. Call me to my shadow.
Ah!
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand. Cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals. Kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. But maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore. But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. Without it, I fear you would have let go of slack. All this time, I've wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountains, trust me. As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.